So this is my Weebly review. It's actually my first look at Weebly and sort of a quick unboxing style review of Weebly. What I'm gonna be looking for is how easy it is to use, is it fairly intuitive, and what you can generally do with it. So what I'm doing this year is I am looking at the top easy to use website builders to help you guys figure out which ones are the best and easiest to use. So when I'm finished looking at all of these different website builders, I'll link down below to my top recommendations for the best website builders to use. So look for that down below. I'm also gonna be creating a bunch of tutorials. Like I'm gonna create several tutorials on how to use Weebly so that you guys can learn how to make a portfolio website, for example, how to create a restaurant or small business website, and then also be looking at how to create a blog with these various different website builders and how to create an online store. And I'll be doing that later on down the road. So if you're interested in those things, be sure to check out the links down below. Right now, let's look at this first look review of Weebly. I'm Tim from realwebsitehints.com, and it's my mission to help you find the best and easiest ways of building great looking websites. All right, so let's go ahead and dive in and take a look at Weebly. It's kind of like an unboxing video for a website builder, and we'll see what it's like. Let's look at the pricing real quick. I looked at it earlier and it does seem really compelling. First of all, you can start with a free version, and I noticed you can even sell online with a shopping cart right in the free version. You don't get your own domain name, but I think that's okay. The personal version, $6 a month, seems to me like a really good deal. You can connect your custom domain, so you don't get a custom domain with that, but if you have registered a domain, I'm guessing, with a third party, you can go ahead and bring that in here. You can also sell online. There's several online store features, not as many online store features as the more advanced feature. It does look like the $6 version does still have ads on it, so you need to step up to the next version to remove those ads. So I think the $6 plan seems like it definitely does everything I want to do right now, which is just try to build a portfolio website, but it even seems like you can sell online. So that seems pretty exciting. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and purchase the $6 plan of Weebly. And if you wanna help support the channel and allow me to buy these tools so I can test them, review them, make my free tutorials, and help you guys just generally find out what the best and easiest ways are of making websites, it would help me out a lot if you use the link down below. It costs you nothing extra and helps to support the channel so I can do these reviews and create the free tutorials that I do on my channel. So I appreciate your support. Okay, so now we've got two options it looks like here. One is I just need a website, and one is I need a website with an online store. And so in this case, I just need a website. So I'm gonna start with that. And okay, we've got a bunch of different options here. We've got a business website, portfolio website, that's what I'm gonna be doing, personal website. So I guess if you're gonna do a wedding, or looks like they also have some portfolio things here. Maybe you're like trying to start a business and you wanna start with that. Creating an event, again, like a wedding. Okay, you're gonna do a blog. So lots of options. So far, I mean, I think what makes these options here look really good is sort of the great pictures that they're using. There's actually not much design that you can see here. So my photography style is really kind of like dark. Let's see, let me pull up some images here from my portfolio. I've got these sort of fire effects photography that I think that's kind of the work that I'm most proud of, and maybe I'd like to do more. It's a lot of fun, you know, to work with fire and take some awesome looking pictures. Then I also have like my product photography, so kind of just basic generic product photography, I'd say, but I do have this sort of like dark twist on it. I like to use these like darker backgrounds, sort of more like industrial kind of a look, I would say. And then I've got some specialty product photography photos that I use, sort of like bigger items, like these kind of like industrial warehouse kind of sets. So this is what I'm gonna be showing off. So this is the kind of look that my photography has, and so I'm gonna be looking for a theme and website design that kind of goes along with this dark look. So it's gonna be a dark website design. So let's see how that works and how that looks. I'm gonna go with this design here. Not really quite as dark as I would like it to be. Let's see what the gallery page looks like. The gallery page looks pretty cool though. I mean, I'm probably being influenced by these awesome photos that are in here. But yeah, generally I like it. And I'm gonna click start editing. And again, I've never used Weebly before, so this is kind of a first for me and for you guys here. So let's see what happens, how easy this is to get started with. Select your domain name. I haven't set up one right now for this website, so I'm just gonna see if it's gonna let me skip it. I can try to connect it later. Okay, let's see if we can go ahead and edit the background image. How would we do that? Edit background. Yep, that's what I want to do. Upload some photos here. Okay, so this is sort of my number one picture. Start with that. See if I can, oh cool, I can move it around too so it kind of fits better with the, that was really easy to do. So far pretty, pretty easy to use. Okay, industrial style photography. Now, one thing that's not working here is the color of this background because my text is not showing up very well. Let me see if I go back to edit image, if this will help. Okay, here we go. There's a darken button. What is it darkening? Is anything happening? Okay. So you gotta click on the darken and then it's lowering it. The text seems to be getting darker also, but let's try that. Let's see how we change the color of this so it's also white. I guess that's pretty good. So far, off to a pretty good start here. Seems fairly easy to use. I'm gonna keep working on it, keep building the site out, and after a couple hours, I'll let you guys know what I find. Okay, so I've been using Weebly for a few hours now. I've built this fairly basic website, kind of a start to my portfolio website that I was working on. And there's definitely a lot of things I like about it. I do feel like these blocks over here that you can just drag in to where you want, add in a title, for example. It's fairly easy to use and I'm enjoying that aspect of it. One of the things, for example, on this title module that I don't like so much are that when you want to increase or decrease the size, it does increase or decrease the size. But when you're designing a page with search engine optimization in mind, for example, you kind of want to know what that HTML tag that's being used for these are. So for example, I'm guessing that the largest size is the H1 tag, and that's kind of what you should be using for like the main titles on your page. And then as you go down the page, different headings and different sections should be laid out using these tags. So the next section should be an H2 tag, and then any headings that you have within that should use like the H3 tag, and any headings within that should use the H4 tag, and so on. So it's basically like creating an outline of your page that Google can see, and you do that by using these headings and using these various different HTML tags the lower down that sort of shows what the indent is on your page outline. But what I'm not seeing is sort of a reference to what tag is being used here. Now there may be some way of seeing that I haven't figured out yet because this is, again, my first look review, but that's something that I feel like they should improve. Oh, another thing to note that I discovered while using Weebly is that I'm a Mac user. I always default to using Safari. Safari does not work very well for Weebly, and that is actually true with a lot of website builders. In general, if you're building a website using an online website builder like Weebly, you want to use Google Chrome. It's just going to work a lot better. Some of the various different options were not showing up in Safari. They show up fine in Google Chrome, so something to keep in mind. One of the other things that threw me a little bit and I had to Google, and it didn't take me long to find, which is a good thing about Weebly, there's a lot of content on the internet about there, but is how do you make a second column? And it's actually really simple. All you do is you grab the block that you want to be part of the second column, and then you look for when it has these sort of blue bars on the sides here, and you just drop that in, and now you've got two columns. One of the things that I've noticed in using Weebly is that these various different blocks, right now I'm having a pretty easy time with it, but they can be a bit fidgety selecting them. This is pretty common with this style of drag and drop builder. One of the WordPress themes that I like is the Divi theme, and I've had sort of the same issue with that. So I think that's just the nature of the drag and drop beast, but it can be a little bit frustrating and a little bit annoying. One of the other things that I've noticed about Weebly in using it is that it's definitely a designer's tool. It's something that if you really like designing your pages and kind of figuring out where everything's gonna go and placing everything. So far, it seems that it will let you do that and it's fairly easy to do. But if you're just trying to build a website super quickly, it can be a bit frustrating and time consuming to lay everything out the way you want it. I just looked at Jimdo Dolphin, which is kind of like their entry level website builder, and has nowhere near the control of this. This gives you a lot more control. But if you're looking to build a website just super quickly, Jimdo is a lot of fun to use. It's kind of like Lego block pieces for your website. You just pick the block you want, you put it in there, you type it, can even change blocks really fast. So if you're curious about that, you know, either check out my Jimdo first look review, my full Jimdo review when I get that out there, or some of the tutorials that I've created on Jimdo. But if you're looking for this kind of full design experience where you've got control over the layout of your pages and everything, and you want to lay everything out yourself, so far Weebly seems like a pretty good way to go. So over here on my gallery page that I created, there definitely is a gallery module that you can use. You can drag this in here and you can upload images. One of the things that I found a little bit frustrating about uploading the images is that it's really easy to do in the gallery section. You can upload several images at once. But something that's kind of been a little bit frustrating to me is some of the images I want to use on several different pages for several different things. And in Weebly, it must be storing my pictures there because they're showing up on my website. But there doesn't seem to be any way for me to access the previously uploaded pictures. Every time I want to add a new picture to a new section or a new module, I've got to re-upload the picture. Which in general is fine, but if, say, I decided I want to work on my website from a different computer and I don't have access to that file, that can be a little bit of a frustration. The other thing I wish that they would work on is an undo function. So say if I drag this image over here and now I, you know, maybe I did that by accident, I didn't even notice what I did. There's no undo button here. And that's something that a lot of other website builders that I've tested have. You can actually even use keyboard shortcuts on other website builders. So you can do like Command Z or maybe, you know, up on the screen up here, there'll be an undo button. And with Weebly, I'm not seeing that. So that's something that would make building your websites a lot easier, especially if you're new to using the platform, like I'm new to using Weebly. Sometimes you just mess up and you just don't know what you did and you just want to be able to hit undo and just put it back the way it was. With Weebly, it doesn't seem like you can do that. So far I've generally liked using Weebly. There's a couple of issues that I've had with it, but I do think that the drag and drop builder aspect of it does seem to work pretty well. It's fairly intuitive and easy to understand. Some of the things are a little bit fidgety, like adjust, you know, getting to the section where you can adjust the background can be a little bit fidgety. Here it is, it popped up here down on the bottom. But I think part of that's also just getting more familiar with it. And again, I've only used this for a couple of hours, so I don't know everything about it yet. But generally, I do think it's a great tool. It does take a little bit more time to build your website, only because you've got full control over the layout and design and you need to do the design. The templates that they create are basically just pre-made ideas of what you can do, and then you can delete what they've already put in there for you and add in what you want. But you're gonna need to kind of do all the layout and design yourself, which is great if that's what you like to do. So I'm gonna be creating some tutorials with Weebly, and I'm gonna be looking at how to make a portfolio website, how to make a small business website, so a website like a restaurant website. I'll also be looking at it as a blogging platform because it does seem like it offers blogging on Weebly. And eventually I'll be looking at how to make an online store using Weebly. And then I'll be doing a full review of Weebly after I've done this and after I've really gotten to know the platform. So you'll find the links to those down in the description below and at the end of this video. And I'll also be creating a roundup of all of the different website building tools that are available, and I'll be giving you my top recommendations on the best website builders you can use to quickly and easily build a website. And I'll include a link to that down below once it's ready. So I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, consider giving me a thumbs up. Think about subscribing to my YouTube channel for these videos that are going to be coming out. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.